Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another episode of Trip Up Trivia. I am your co-host this evening, Jesse Starcher, and we are going to be discussing Disney trivia this go-round. That's right. It's a contest between four people to find out who knows the most about Walt Disney movies, Walt Disney TV shows, and Walt Disney theme parks. So real quick, before I turn it over to my co-host here, Alexis Hanna, I will go ahead and go down through our introductions. Creator of Tolland Books, Zachary Strobel. Zachary Strobel, are you ready, sir?
Yes, I am.
He is ready. He's ready. Ready to rock and roll. Disney trivia. Pumped up. Here we go. Now, she is the only person capable of dealing with our boss more than we are. She is the wife. The matriarch? There's the patriarch of the Radulich and Broadcasting Network, and then there's the matriarch. So I guess Melissa Radulich is the matriarch of the Radulich and Broadcasting Network. Melissa, thank you very much for joining us. Are you ready?
I think so.
All right, fantastic. Part of the Canadian office, you can catch him talking Star Trek with some of the other sci-fi locals on the network recently. His name is David Wright. We're turning back to the show. You played before, and I think you won, if I remember correctly, right?
Yeah, we'll see if lightning strikes twice. I'm not expecting it to, but we'll see how it goes.
And a man who should be too old to care about podcasts or Disney, a Gold Circle patron of Kapow, the Pop Culture Podcast, and a two-time winner of his mother's Best in Children Award, it is Justin Lowe. I said, hey, Justin, you want to talk of some Disney trivia? Actually, I just threw the invite out there open to anybody. And you know what? This man waved in Disney somehow. I don't know how somebody waves in Disney, but Justin Lowe waved in Disney. So Justin, are you ready to try some Disney trivia tonight?
I am ready. Waving in Disney is easy. It's a regular wave that costs you $27.
Okay. Perfect. All right. Without further ado, I want to turn this over to Alexis Hanna. Alexis, you have the floor.
Oh, thank you so much, Jesse. Contestants, I'm so excited to get started. Are you guys ready to play?
Yeah.
Ready?
Yep.
Yes.
All right. Now, before we begin, for those who have never listened to our show before, we're going to do a quick summation of the rules here. We are going to go through two rounds. Each round has three categories. Each category has five questions each. Tonight's categories are divided up Disney movie, Disney TV shows, and Disney parks. Now, for the sake of keeping this from spiraling into the massive conglomeration of, oh my God, I didn't even realize Disney owned that, we have tried to keep this as central to classic Disney as we could. So this, we're not going to be talking Star Wars or Marvel or Fox or any of the other stuff, unless this is a specific area in one of the parks that deals with those. We are not going to be talking about the extra purchases that the mouse has made in recent years. All right. Well, if there is no other questions, then we will go ahead and get started with our first five questions on Disney movie trivia. Question number one, which Disney film series included actors Ken Berry, Buddy Hackett, Don Knotts, and Bruce Campbell in the reboot?
This is coming out of your paycheck, Hank. No, this is your paycheck.
It wasn't even a good race. I mean, come on. Rudy Walters? I used to race circles around guys like Walters.
I think they called that spinning out.
All right, all answers are in. Zachary and Justin got it right. It was Herbie the Love Bug.
I love those movies, too.
Question number two. Adapted from a Hans Christian Andersen story, this film was released in November of 1989 and was Disney's first animated adaptation of a fairy tale since Sleeping Beauty. What is the movie?
So before they go back into the Disney vault for years to come, hurry. Don't miss your chance to own these magical Disney videos before they disappear.
One holds a special place in my heart. That was childhood right there.
It's a good thing I went to college for animation. That's 4 years.
All right, everyone's answers are in, and you all got it right. What's the movie, guys?
Little Mermaid.
Very good.
Everyone.
I wanted red hair so bad.
My sister's name is Ariel, and she was born about the same time as that movie was made. So let's just say her whole room is decorated with Ariel stuff.
Wow.
what an amazing coincidence.
No kidding.
Question number three. Which 1992 animated film co-starring Robin Williams won 2 Academy Awards for Best Original Score and Best Original Song?
I feel like I started out pretty hard, and then
that's
now we're just like, so let's coast.
I can be anything. I can be
just a tiny person,
or make my eyes really big, or maybe have legs that are real long.
I can even be you, Walter Cronkite.
Now hold on there.
Can I do this? I'm happy. I'm grumpy. I'm dopey.
Hi, everybody. I'm a corporate symbol.
Hold it! Hold it! Whoa! Are you fellas finished?
I always wanted to do that.
Okay, because, yeah, you guys did not waste any time. Everyone got that answer in, and you, once again, you all got it right.
Yay!
Aladdin.
I almost said Hook, but then, wait a minute, there are no original songs in Hook.
Does anyone know what the song was that won the best original song that year? Which song from Aladdin?
A Whole New World.
Mm-hmm.
Got a Friend in Me?
No. Negative one.
We're not that mean.
I didn't realize that was a question. Oh, man, you guys are tough.
Question number four. Which live-action film series started in 2003, starring Johnny Depp, and at the time of this recording, has 5 films grossing a worldwide box office of $4.5 billion?
That's incredible that it's that much.
I know, right?
I think it's sad.
I think it's even better that they didn't even want to make it.
Mm.
Well, I have this feeling I'm just going to go ahead and put ones across the board right now.
Yeah.
I think saying it was Johnny Depp starring in it was the giveaway.
Yeah, really, you could have just shortened that question down to Johnny Depp.
Johnny Depp.
Pirates of the Caribbean.
Avatar of Dirt.
Has anybody actually been on the Pirates of the Caribbean ride since they've updated to coincide with the franchise?
Like 130 times.
I've never been to any Disney theme parks, which is probably not going to do me well in the theme park section. I know I'm missing out. Unfortunately, things cost money.
Yeah.
You got ways to drive too.
Yes.
Like, I'm 45 minutes away from Disney, like door to door. It's 45 minutes.
Yeah. Like, I'm pretty sure Mark just lives right next to the property line.
Close. We're pretty close. He doesn't like to go with me anymore, though. He's no fun. He's a killjoy.
All right. Question number 5. This is the last question in the first round of movie trivia. In 2012, Walt Disney Animation Studios released an animated film starring a character that is a villain in an arcade game, but goes on to become a hero. I need the name of that character. I'd like to add that to this day, I'm still ticked off that they didn't incorporate this movie as a level in the last Kingdom Hearts game. Could have had a classic 8-bit side-scroller. It writes itself.
Right.
So, and they all got
that's like you're such a lazy writer, you can't even be bothered to do the most obvious thing.
Well, I would have liked that better than the Frozen level of Kingdom Hearts 3, which was pretty much just a walk through the movie and a scene of Sora, Donald, and Goofy climbing up the mountain to the song Let It Go. It's like, yeah, that's the reason I want to play this game. Listen to that for the umpteenth time.
And that's really the worst advice you could ever give someone when climbing a mountain. Let it go. Yeah.
I'm surprised they all got it right, Jesse.
What they really need to do is for Kingdom Hearts is like every time Goofy's involved, have the narrator from like the Goofy how-to cartoons narrate everything he does.
Oh, yes.
So the correct answer was Ralph. This is a score rundown for the first round. Very, very, very close game. So we have a tie for third. David and Melissa both have 4 points, and there is a tie for first right now. Going perfect, both Justin and Zachary. So we are moving on into television, right?
Yep, Disney TV shows.
You took all the questions from the Mighty Ducks, right?
Yeah, every single one of them. How did you know?
Well, you do know that would have to be the Mighty Duck TV series.
Yes, as in the animated one about the alien ducks playing hockey.
There it is. How did he know?
Which was really only bearable because they had Tim Curry and Tony Jay playing the villains.
Jeez, I hope none of these are related to the questions.
No, they're not. I went out of my way not to put that show on this.
Yeah. The planet they were from was called Puck World. That should have been a question.
The asteroids were all shaped like pucks.
Yes.
Oh my God. It scares me that I actually remember stuff about that show.
How can you not?
Great cells with alcohol.
Sounds like I got a clip to find on YouTube to put in the podcast again.
Oh, so many clips. We're not even at the magic golden hockey mask.
I would say just get the theme song where they all shout "Ducks rock."
Okay.
Love it that they bought the hockey team just so they could merchandise it.
That's what does best.
Yeah, like when they bought the RCMP. True story.
I don't know what that is, but
Royal Canadian Mounted Police, the Canadian guys that wear.
Oh, thank you,
Red Dudley Do-Right.
Dudley Do-Right works for Disney now?
They bought the merchandising rights for the Royal Canadian Mounted Police so they could make a Dudley Do-Right movie with Brendan Fraser.
Oh God,
I love that movie.
I'm sure Disney will just buy Canada. Just Canada.
Yeah. Do it.
Just turn all of Canada into one gigantic theme park.
Oh, no. It would be
Canada. That's basically what it is.
You've got to, like, make the borders like a set of ears that go right on top of the United States. Just Canada's a big set of Disney ears.
Yeah. All the toll booths are replaced with ticket booths.
Oh, that's wonderful. All right. What's the question, Alexis?
I was going to say, I was at Disneyland recently, or Disney World, and I went to Epcot, and the Canadian Food Center was actually pretty good.
Mm-hmm. I'm curious as to what they had. Was it just poutine and maple syrup?
No, they did awesome cheddar soup there.
Yes, that beer cheese soup is to die for.
That's
exactly what you need when it's 90 degrees in Orlando. I'm like, soup.
Any Nanaimo bars?
I saw those.
I don't think I've ever noticed those.
Fail.
See, I fell in love with apple pie shots. Now, those were good. All right. First question for Disney TV shows trivia. What is the series that starred twins Dylan and Cole Sprouse, whose characters get into misadventures at the Tipton Hotel?
This just makes me giggle. I loved this show.
Don't forget to pack Blanky. Don't eat it. I'm quitting cold turkey. But it might come in handy. Say you run into a grizzly bear. You could take out your blankie, and he would laugh himself to death. Or I can show him your report card.
All right, all answers are in. Sorry, David. Drake and Josh was actually a Nickelodeon property.
Oh.
It sounded like a Disney thing, and it had two boys' names, because that was the best I could come up with.
It's a good show, though. I like it.
But everyone else got that right. The Sweet Life of Zach and Cody.
Good thing I got that. My name is Zach, so.
All right. Question number two. Which video game, released for the Nintendo Entertainment System in 1989 and based on the 1987 TV series of the same name, finds its main character collecting treasures through stages and fighting the likes of Flintheart, Glomgold, and Magicka Dispel?
We invited an expert team to our laboratory to give us their opinions of Disney's video game from Capcom.
Yes! Awesome!
You'll have exciting adventures helping escape danger and become the Ring World.
Cool. Totally hot. Way radical, man! Excellent!
Join this gang in Disney's for Nintendo by Capcom. Also, look for Mickey Mouse Capade.
It's a quacker! Oh!
Answers are in. Zachary, David, and Melissa got it right. The name of the video game based off of the TV show with the single biggest earworm of a theme song is DuckTales. Woohoo!
Ooh. Have you heard the new version of the theme song?
Oh, God, yeah. New series.
I love it.
I picked the wrong stupid duck.
Darkwing?
Yeah.
Aren't they in the same universe now? Like the duck universe or whatever it is for Disney?
Yeah. They are. They in the new series. Nobody knows for sure. Bad guys are out of luck. Here comes. Okay, got the question here.
All right.
Which iconic duo first introduced in a 1994 landmark animated film would go on to have their own TV show 1 year later?
Everybody's
Okay, answers are all in. The answer is Timon and Pumbaa.
Ooh, yes! Yeah.
Did not.
Yep, the 1994 landmark animated film was, of course, The Lion King.
All right, who got the points?
Justin, Zachary, and David. Melissa, good attempt, but Chip and Dale were not in Lion King. And if
that
they
is
were,
where... Then- That's where I was going.
Two that were coming into my brain.
Yeah.
That was my first guess, too. But then I was like, 1994, that's way too late.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, if Chip and Dale were in Lion King, they were probably eaten by the hyenas.
But I kind of almost wonder now. They're pretty.
There was a cameo somewhere in there, I'm convinced.
Yeah, to the tape.
Maybe there was a couple of chipmunk skeletons in with all the antelopes or something.
Oh,
one had a Magnum P.I. shirt, all in tatters, an Indiana Jones hat. I'm ruining so many childhoods right now.
All right. Question number four. In 2006, Hannah Montana aired starring which real-life singer?
Who would have thought that a girl like me would double as a superstar?
Sorry, David's the only one who got that wrong. The answer is Miley Cyrus.
I mean, they're all basically the same person.
What did he guess? Well, I want to hear it.
I went Hillary Duff, but...
Duff never grinded with a foam finger on the VMA.
You know, I'm sure I was thinking Miley Cyrus, just the name just left my mind right when you asked the question. So it was just like, oh, geez, which one of the, like, five different girls that had alternate names in sitcoms? I can't keep it straight.
Question number five. Prior to landing a role in Spider-Man Homecoming, you could find this actress starring as a spy in the Disney show KC Undercover.
I'm pretty sure Hilary Duff wasn't in any of the Marvel Spider-Man movies.
She was a skeleton in the background, I think, if I remember right.
You took the word from my mouth. I was like, there's a cameo somewhere.
Yeah, so this is turning into like Aliens versus Predator. Is there going to be like the team-up movie now? Hilary Duff versus Spider-Man?
What happened?
Answers are in. The correct answer is Zendaya. Zachary, David, and Melissa all got that right.
It is time for a score update, ladies and gentlemen. Right now, in fourth place, David Wright with 7 points. We have a tie for second place between Justin and Melissa with 8. And Zachary is running away with this. 2 rounds, 5 points apiece. He's got a total of 10. So... are we ready for the third? Park time. I have a feeling there's going to be some people that are going to flex some strength on this one.
All right. Before we continue, David and Melissa both mentioned the frequency in which you have been to any of the parks. Justin, Zachary, have you guys been to either Disneyland or Disney World in recent memory?
I've been to both. The last time I was at Disney World was actually this year in March. So back when they were starting to open everything up. And Disneyland, I haven't been to since 2017. So I haven't been to the Star Wars place. I imagine it's changed a lot in the past 4 years.
Yeah, I've been Orlando probably 12, 14, 15 times. Anaheim 3 or 4, I think. I don't remember the last time I was there. Time has ceased to have any meaning at this point, but I know we're going back in June, so yay.
Awesome. Yeah, I was just there in August. I was working a convention down in Orlando and decided to go down early and enjoy a nice long vacation at the park.
Yep.
My first vacation in I don't know how long. Loved it.
1987, I think, for me. 86 or 87. I just remember we'd stay at my grandpa's and then we'd drive over to Disney and, you know, do the park thing. But I remember watching Ghostbusters for the first time on HBO, eating a full bag of Skittles at like 11 o'clock at night and getting sick to my stomach, but loving the movie. So that's one of my favorite memories of going down and that year that we went to Disney. So,
all right. Question number one, which Disney park ride may get you a peek at, quote, the backside of water?
Oh, dear.
That's a fun one to do at Christmas time.
Oh, yeah.
They change it up.
I'm expecting to be slaughtered.
Wonder of the world. It's the backside of water. All right, answers are all in. David, Melissa, and Justin, you got it right. It's the Jungle Cruise.
Woohoo! One of the two rides I know of that involve water.
All right, question number two. Located in Tomorrowland at Disney World, this attraction opened in 1975 and is described as riding in near darkness with a few unforeseen drops that may have you feeling as though you're traveling at the speed of light.
The Ghost Galaxy and World of Color Nighttime Water Spectacular. Halloween time at the Disneyland Resort is wicked fun for everyone.
Trick or treat! Answers are all in, and everyone got that right. It is Space Mountain.
Which is the best.
I hate to say it, actually. That's the ride that I got a little motion sickness on.
Oh, I love that ride.
There's a fantastic picture. We sent my brother and his wife and my nieces and nephews down a couple of years ago for a Christmas present. So it's my brother and my two nephews who were probably, I don't know, 12 and 10 or so at the time. So there's three seats in a row. So my brother's in the back and the two kids are in front of him. And my brother's laughing. The youngest nephew, who is just completely fearless, has this look on his face like, yeah, this is fun. And the middle one, or the older one, who was not enjoying himself, has this look, just abject horror on his face. Apparently, the entire ride, he kept screaming, we're not in space, we're not in space, we're not in space, we're not in space. So, of course, you know he's 12
trying
years
to convince himself.
Mock the crap. Yeah, exactly. He was just trying to, it was a mantra to keep him grounded that they were not actually flying through space. So that one will come back out, you know, when he picks up his prom date or, you know, his high school graduation or something fun.
Wedding reception.
Exactly. Let's go to the slides.
I think one of my proudest moments was when I got to put both my kids on that ride.
Oh, you're going to have so much ammo from this podcasting thing with your kids on it when they get married.
I can't
It's going to be glorious. let's watch the 5-minute supercut of Jonas shaking his butt at the camera.
Yes! Question number three is a fill in the blank. Located in Disneyland, Blank's cartoon spin is based on a film that featured the first and only time that Mickey Mouse and Bugs Bunny shared the screen together.
At Disneyland, you've seen Fantasyland, Frontierland, and Tomorrowland. Now here's a whole new land you've never seen before.
Hey! That new show's round. Take this crazy town. It's a special style.
The Mickey's Toontown, new at Disneyland. Answers are all in. Melissa, Zachary, and Justin got it right. It's Roger Rabbit.
Did you hear they're actually renovating Toontown, though, mm-hmm. for 2023?
Yeah, apparently they're adding a bunch of green space and really kind of renovating it and trying to bring it up to date. So,
yeah. I mean, I love Toontown, but I do agree. It is pretty dated, and you really can't interact as much as you probably should. So I actually think that's a good idea.
All right, question number four. What attraction includes 950,000 gallons of water, three dips, a 5-story drop, and is currently being remodeled to feature characters from The Princess and the Frog? And it slows down every time I try to ride it.
I have issue with that update. Like, I love Princess and the Frog. Like, it's a great movie, but man, I hate when they mess with classics.
Disney will not stop until those original characters are wiped from existence.
Yep.
Never forget.
All right, answers are all in. The correct answer is Splash Mountain. Melissa, Zachary, and Justin got that right. David, they are not remodeling. It's a Small World.
That is a true statement.
The closest thing I could think of was like Pirates of the Caribbean, but no, why would they add Princess and the Frog? I thought I almost had it when you said they want to like get rid of those old characters.
Like I said, I went down in August, otherwise known as monsoon season in Florida. Yep. And yeah, every time I got in line for Splash Mountain, it shut down because it was either thundering and lightning. So they had to shut it down, or it just kept breaking down. And I remember talking to one of the workers in front, and he just looked at me as like, it's one of our most popular attractions. It's water and electricity. It's that hundreds of people riding it a day. You really think this thing's going to actually be able to keep going?
Yes.
So yeah. Oh my. Everyone's like, you didn't go on Splash Mountain. I tried.
Oh, could I say maybe they should add a 5-story foot fall to It's a Small World? Mix it up a little
bit.
Make
it more interesting.
I'd go for that.
The way that Small World ride backs up at the exit, it would just be cars dropping it on top of other cars. Well,
yeah, my point still stands.
It's a painful world.
Okay, number five. Due to its aggravating and messy nature, which item is not sold anywhere on Disney World property?
I know this one.
I am so proud of this question for some reason.
There is no rule that says you can't bring it in, but you will not find it sold in any of the parks.
Sorry, folks, park's closed. The moose out front should have told you.
Yes, we're here to see Mr. Roy Wally.
What is your name, sir?
Clark W. Griswold.
What's this regarding, Mr. Grizzle?
We're here for public amusement relations, or this is a summer inspection to a personal matter.
Ah.
All right, answers are all in. Yeah, Zachary, it's not cocaine.
Oh.
How could you think of Disney and not cocaine? Like,
well, you have to think about maybe that's how they came up with some of the rides, some of the ideas.
That was deep.
I mean, there's a ride there where they throw, where you put you in a log and they throw you off another log. I mean, come on.
Actually, it's not alcohol either, and it is not tobacco. Melissa and Justin got this right. It's gum.
Disney World in Singapore.
So, I guess you could say they got into a lot of sticky situations.
Yeah, no, you can get plenty of alcohol in the Disney parks. Actually, when I went to Epcot Center during the last time I went to the Epcot Center was the International Food and Wine Festival. I bought something that I have never been able to find a way to reproduce it. It's a key lime mimosa. It was so good.
How you celebrate turning 21? You drink around the world and then you go ride test track because you're drinking and driving.
Perfect.
University of Florida, like that's what we did. Turn 21. All right, let's go to Disney World. We're going to drink around the world. We're going to get on test track and then vomit everywhere. Great.
Disney magic at its finest.
I'm sure the employees appreciated that.
I'm classy.
Classy. All right, it's the end of the first round. We're going to get into the tougher questions here in a second, but it is time for a score update. David Wright, you're in fourth place right now with a total of 9 points.
I did better than I thought in that round.
That's good. That's good.
I got more than zero questions right.
That is correct.
You didn't write Scott Bakula as any of the answers this time.
Oh, hey, we still got a whole other round to go. Okay, so Justin, Melissa, and Zachary are all tied for first place right now with a total of 13 points. So, before we get to round two, it's time to quickly tell you about Amazon Music. If you enjoy rocking out to some great tunes, head to getamazonmusic.com/W2M network. You can get a free 30-day trial where you can check out over 70 million songs. That's getamazonmusic.com/W2M network for that free 30-day trial. Now, let's get back to our game. Second round. What happens here in the second round again, Alexis?
Second round, the questions are harder, and they are going to be 2 points each. So, how many brothers does Prince Hans of the Southern Isles have in Frozen?
Son of a...
You know what? I will go ahead and give you guys a couple of options here. We'll make this multiple choice, make it a little bit easier on you. Does he have 5 brothers, 7 brothers, 12 brothers, or 11 brothers?
Well, when I had it narrowed down to 2 and both are options, that's not overly helpful.
I'm going with my gut on this one because it's the only thing I have.
Princess Anna has given her orders.
And that's another thing. Has it dawned on you that your princess may be conspiring with a wicked sorceress to destroy us all?
Do not question the princess. She left me in charge, and I will not hesitate to protect Arendelle from treason.
Treason?
Okay, all answers are in. No one got that right.
All right, I haven't lost any ground.
Believe it or not, Hans has 12 brothers.
Oh,
he is the youngest of 13 sons.
That's quite the queen, assuming there was just one.
Yeah, he's got a line in there about 12 brothers, but I didn't remember if he had 12 brothers or he was the 12th brother, so...
Was it 12 brothers or 11 brothers? I wanted that. Like I said, questions are a little harder.
A lot of
just
kids
a bit.
College. I mean, I know they're the queen, but still.
All right, next question. Though often used as a generic term to describe the romantic interest, which animated film actually named their royal heartthrob Prince Charming?
Now, if you ladies would please have a seat, the prince will be right with you.
My prince.
Highness.
Hello.
Yep, and no one got it right. I'm afraid that we had three guesses for Snow White and one for Sleeping Beauty. Snow White actually has a name, and believe it or not, it is Prince Florian. I don't know who picked that name, but that is the official canon name. And Sleeping Beauty's prince is named Philip. Prince Charming is in Cinderella. Yeah.
The problem is, in Once Upon a Time, Snow White falls for Prince Charming. And so that's what threw me off. Thanks a lot.
Well, that's I'm liking this round. The only definitive answer I had was like Shrek 2, but not a Disney film.
Next question. What is the name of the pub that Flynn brings Rapunzel to in Tangled?
Hey, just a sec, I'll check. Amanda Hug and Kiss? Hey, I'm looking for Amanda Hug and Kiss. Why can't I find Amanda Hug and Kiss?
Maybe your standards are too high.
Little SOB.
Okay, answers are all... Oh, Zachary, that's adorable. He said Moe's.
Moe's? Nice.
I think Robert Winfrey's ears just started burning.
That's a natural state.
Justin, you're the only one who got it right. The name of the pub is the Snuggly Duckling.
Oh, I was close.
Yeah, Melissa wrote the Ugly Duckling, but that's not it.
I got a dream. I got a dream.
give me who got it and who didn't.
Justin's the only one who got that one right.
Okay.
I've watched that movie like one time. I don't know.
Yeah, same.
But
good best song of the film, definitely.
Yeah. I personally think that movie's better than Frozen.
Kind of is.
Mm-hmm.
It's sort of the proto-Frozen, but still, yeah. Pretty good.
Question number 9. Fantasia... I'm sorry. By the way, this one is multiple choice. Fantasia features animated sequences set to pieces of classical music written by some of the greatest composers of all time. But which of the following did not have their work included in the 1940 film? Was it Bach, Handel, Beethoven, or Tchaikovsky? I had to include this. Fantasia is my personal all-time favorite Disney film. Well, all-time favorite entirely animated film, because my all-time favorite movie is Who Framed Roger Rabbit. But I know there's kind of like a gray area on whether or not you really call that a Disney film, because it's Amblin Entertainment, so, yeah. You know.
Plus Touchstone, which kind of just Disney's guy.
Yeah, there's always a joke. It's like that when Disney does Touchstone, they're waiting to see if it turns out to be like Nightmare Before Christmas or if it turns out to be like Strange Music.
Which is weird, because the movie's PG, and I mean, Black Cauldron was PG, so I don't understand. I mean, if it was PG-13, I can understand, but I never understood why it had to go Touchstone, because they made plenty of PG movie.
Oh, sure. All right. Answers are all in. David Wright, you're the only one who got that right. It was Handel.
Yes.
Yep.
I'm sure Tchaikovsky was one of them.
The Nutcracker Suite is one of the featured pieces. Bach and Beethoven both have their music shared.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure Bach would have been one of them. So I really narrowed it down to just Handel or Beethoven and took a guess.
All right.
Or, I mean, that was so obvious. Like, I can't believe none of you guys knew that.
Edit
that in.
Okay, I'll keep that one in.
Actually, don't edit it. Just include me saying edit that in, and then
leave it a mystery.
All right, we got one last question here in the movie round. Disney has created some of the most iconic villains of all time, but which one never actually appeared on screen in their respective film?
Like the film with their name in the title, or just like a film that where they were the main villain?
The film where they were the main villain. They never appear on screen.
And this is an animated movie?
It is.
Okay.
You need movie or character?
It is a classic animated Disney film.
It's not Jeffrey Katzenberg, is it?
I think he gets a point just for that.
He was in the shot. The camera just panned right over top of his head. You didn't see him.
two answers in.
Trying to remember all the Disney classic animated movies now.
It's actually interesting. Not only does this villain never appear on screen, but in AFI's top 100 heroes and villains list, the villain is on the list.
Wow. How far? Like, pretty low or high on that list?
I'm trying to remember. I hate to say it. The only one I remember, obviously, was number one, which is Hannibal Lecter.
Okay. All right.
I'm trying to remember. I think this one was in the 20s.
I'm just trying to think of, like, a Disney movie with a villain that's not in it.
Yeah. This is a good question.
Yeah, because you know who the villain is.
Yeah,
you know,
dude, can't wait till this answer's given.
Oh, geez, yeah, this one's racking me hard. This is the only film I can think of that might not have a villain visible on screen. You won't hurt my feelings.
Does Lady and the Tramp have a villain?
I don't even remember the plot. And the spaghetti scene was iconic.
Of course.
I mean, yeah.
But the villain in question is Man, and the movie is Bambi.
Oh, I didn't call him Man.
You said Hunter? Jesse, I'm assuming Hunter from Bambi. I'm assuming we'll take that.
Yeah, I mean, I have no problem with that. That's fine.
All right. Melissa, Justin, and Zachary got that right.
Wow. Very good. Well, score update real quick. Hey, we're at the end of that first round, which was movies. So 2 points apiece. It looks like David still in fourth. You got 11 points. We have a tie for second place now between Melissa and Zachary. Justin has moved ahead with a total of 17 points. So it's Justin 17, Melissa and Zachary with 15, and David with 11.
I like how I'm in fourth, and then like we just jump straight to second place. So...
All right. Shall we move on to the second round of EV trivia?
Do it.
All right. First question. The Mickey Mouse Club was known for launching the careers of several actors and pop stars. But of the four following, which did not get their start in the 1989 revival of the series? Was it Britney Spears, Ryan Gosling, Scarlett Johansson, or Justin Timberlake? All right, all answers are in. The correct answer, the only one of those four who did not get their start on the Mickey Mouse Club was Scarlett Johansson.
Yay!
Oh, that's my second guess.
Yep. Mickey Mouse Club gave rise to Britney Spears, Ryan Gosling, Justin Timberlake, Christina Aguilera, and so many more.
I think the only question related to the Mickey Mouse Club I could actually answer is who's the leader of the club that's made for you and me?
You know, with Grammarly.com, it would be you and I.
Oh, wait a second.
don't take that away from me. I'm the one with the segue.
You got that one, Alexis. Help me out. I know it wasn't David. David's got a zero.
Everyone else got it right.
Okay. All right. Go. MickeyMouseMouse.
Next question. In the show Phineas and Ferb, Perry the Platypus is a secret agent. But what is the name of his arch enemy?
So stick with us, cause Phineas and Ferb are gonna do it all. So stick with us, cause Phineas and Ferb are gonna do it all.
Mom! Phineas and Ferb are making a title sequence!
David, are you even trying?
I am way too old for that.
Way too old for trying?
No, as in way... Way too old for Phineas and Ferb.
Oh, okay, got it.
That is in my blind spot.
Yeah.
Perry the Platypus's archenemy is Dr. Heinz Doofenshmirtz. I think I'm pronouncing that right. David just wrote Arch.
Arch. The archenemy.
Yes, the archenemy. Very, very meta. I thought that was pretty good considering I haven't ever seen a single episode.
Yeah, solid guess. How about the rest of the people? What do we got?
Everyone else got that right. Melissa's spelling was a little off, but it's close enough. We'll let it slide.
Yeah, I don't know how you could get that perfect. What a name.
Like I said, it's a funky last name. Next question. The animated show Gargoyles featured several voice actors that had previously appeared on Star Trek.
Yes!
I think he might, if he gets it wrong, it's going to be a big letdown.
Which actor played the main antagonist, David Xanatos?
I think David's keyboard caught fire.
the only thing I've typed faster was V for the science fiction one. Can I get bonus points for naming the other two?
You would need them. You get respect. How's that?
Bragging rights.
Hold on, David, quit typing names, okay?
Oh, sorry. There was actually, I found another one too.
And this person didn't get the role.
He's typing the names of all of the Star Trek actors who appeared on the show. Because you are right. Yeah, Brent Spiner, Marina Sirtis, and Michael Dorn all did make appearances on the show. But the correct answer is
Jonathan Frakes.
Very good. Very good. Who got it right?
Zachary and, I guess that's it.
Zachary and David?
Yes.
Okay.
Next question. What are the names of Kim Possible's genius twin brothers?
Oh, yeah, yeah. I'm your basic average girl, and I'm here to save the world. You can't stop me because I'm Kim Possible.
Not my favorite, but the theme song was really catchy.
Oh, it was a nice theme song.
Yeah, that show was a voice actor's haven. They got some of the best in the business to all do roles on that. I still love Patton Oswalt as Dr. Dementor. Or Professor Dementor, that's it. It's like, wait, no, that's I'm thinking of Dr. Dementor, something different. No, Professor Dementor. That was an awesome character.
Shame he never graduated from evil medical school.
All right. Answers are all in. Melissa's the only one who got that right. The answers are Jim and
Tim. Jim and Tim?
That is the name of the twins.
Wow.
I knew they had to rhyme or be alliterative.
Well, boy, yeah. This is a close game, I'll tell you.
Yeah, let's see here. David guessed Tom and Todd. Justin guessed Larry and Daryl. And Zach.
Bob Sorry. Newhart.
Sorry.
And your other brother, Daryl.
Exactly.
And Zachary guessed Mo and Larry.
Oh, nice. Very nice.
Okay, last question in the TV round. In Gravity Falls, the Dipper twins find a mysterious journal that helps them solve the town's mysteries. But who do they discover wrote the journal?
This is the one. I don't watch this one. Yeah,
same
I
here.
I did not get this one right.
I am a generation too late for some of these questions.
And this is what, like, Lily and Jonas don't watch this one that I know of.
I do like my answer. So,
all right.
It's wrong, but I like it.
All right, answers are all in, and yeah, no one got this right. The correct answer is it's their great uncle's twin brother, Stanford Pines.
Oh, geez, now you said it's so obvious.
Stanford Pine.
Melissa guessed it was their grandfather. Zachary, you guessed another character from the show, Bill, but it was not Bill Cipher. Justin guessed Dr. Albert Falls.
Albert Falls.
Gravity Falls? I thought, you know, the famous guy that Schweitzer Falls is named after. So
sure.
And David wrote Scott Bakula.
Hey,
it was time.
Yes,
we've dodged that bullet so far. It was time to pull the trigger.
All right.
His relationship to the protagonists are just minorly less confusing than the relationship between Dark Helmet and Lone Star.
That was the only thing going through my head.
Before you die, there is something you should know about us, Lone Star.
What?
I am your father's brother's nephew's cousin's former roommate.
What's that make us?
Absolutely nothing. Which is what you are about to become.
Third.
Yeah, so what does that make us? Absolutely nothing. Which is what you will soon be.
Perfect. All right. At the end of that second tougher round there, scores are as follows. We have David Wright with 13 points sitting in fourth place and a tie for first. Sorry, Dave. We jumped another spot ahead there.
So I'm not good enough for second or third now?
Tie for first right now. It is Justin, Melissa, and Zachary with a total of 21 points. And we are about to hit this final round. I don't know what's going to happen here at the end of things if there's a tie. I know you said you may have some backup questions. That might just have to happen. I don't know. But let's see how parks are going to affect the scores here. So, Alexis, you have the floor.
I don't foresee it changing much for me.
David Wright went perfect, and everybody else got zero. Winner of the... Okay, never mind.
Well, there's still room for fifth place, I guess.
All right, we're going back to the Disney parks. First question. When visiting Galaxy's Edge, which planet do the guests go to? Is it Alderaan, Coruscant, Batu, or Jakku?
Oh, I'm stuck between two.
And per the usual, you don't have to get the spelling right. I am not going to ask anyone here to know how to spell any of these.
Is it there, or there?
I know which one it's not.
Thank you for joining the cause, and may the Force be with us.
You ready?
Are you?
All right, all answers are in. The correct answer is it's the planet Batu.
Yay!
Yes.
Justin, David, and Melissa got that right.
I only know that because everyone was complaining how Galaxy's Edge didn't take place at any of the actual Star Wars planets. Because those are old IP. We're making new IP that everyone will love. This can't possibly go wrong.
I think it's more along the lines of we really don't want to deal with some nerds saying, this is incorrect. Coruscant and Alderaan have this over here. By putting it at Batu, which really hasn't been seen anywhere in the star or in the universe prior, we're allowed to let our be a little more creative.
But I would just have everyone sign a waiver when they enter in saying if they make any nerdy pedantic stuff like that, stormtroopers are authorized to use lethal force.
Won't they miss though?
Well, maybe they don't use their blasters.
The World Showcase in Epcot showcases the culture, cuisine, architecture, and traditions of how many countries?
I'm literally going through them in my head right now.
Are you counting them?
Yes.
Wow. Is it like the Animaniac song?
Yeah, in my head, I know how you go around it. I'm like sitting here, like in my head, like literally, like ticking them off.
Nice.
I think my favorite one that I went to, ironically, was Japan, because when I went in the gift shop at the end of touring the part of Japan, all the stuff that's in there, it's basically like walking into an anime convention. So I see all these people freaking out and geeking out over all this stuff, and I'm just like, average weekend for me.
Yeah, actually, Alexis, funny, interesting thing about that, that store is actually a legitimate Japanese department store called Mitsukoshi. Yeah, and they actually, it is a Mitsukoshi department store.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, that was... Okay, so I lived in Japan for a little while, and that was like the nicest department store ever. And it was so funny because when we come back, that is like the only place I can go and still find like a lot of, you know, like the traditional snacks and stuff that I was missing for a long time.
Yeah, our trip that we're doing in June, we think we're going to take an afternoon or a part of our day at Epcot or one of our days at Epcot and essentially send the five or six of us throughout the store and basically buy something and everybody's got to try it.
Yes, there's some really great stuff there.
Yeah.
I love that place.
All right. Well, all answers are in. The correct answer is 11 countries. Melissa and Justin got that right.
I was closer than I thought. Yes.
All right. Next question. Employees who help build and create the theme parks and attractions for Disney are known as what?
I always wanted to be one of these when I was a kid.
There was a standard that surprised people. So they left thinking, wow, how did Disney do that?
This is a dream that started in Anaheim that's traveled the world.
Answers are all in. The correct answer is Imagineers.
Imagineers right, on the top of the United States. Go ahead.
Melissa, David, and Justin got it right. All right. Next question. When visiting the Haunted Mansion, what is the name of the vehicle that takes you through the ride? I was determined to make sure that at least one question about the Haunted Mansion got into this contest.
999 Happy Haunt.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, the one thing that wasn't in the Muppet movie.
Love it that. Actually was.
Oh, yeah, it was. This was in there, yeah.
I just so
it's subtle, but...
That the Muppet's Haunted Mansion, they didn't get Electric Mayhem to do a cover of Grim Grinning Ghost. So it's like, are you kidding me? That is one of the one things I wanted.
Yeah. Okay. So I recently at my school, we got a new assistant principal and he started his first day was October 29th, which was, you know, the Friday before Halloween. So all through school, everybody is doing random Halloween stuff because, you know, that's what you do when you teach in an elementary school. So the first time my new assistant principal ever meets me, I actually have to say the words to him. First words out of my mouth were, hold on, let me turn down my Grim Grinning Ghost so I can introduce myself because I was playing it on repeat while we were doing a math activity.
Best thing is if he could make like a head cast of the former vice principal and just carry that around with him.
Yeah. Oh, that would be great.
Feel free to use that one.
Yeah.
Answers are all in. Melissa and Justin got it right. It is the Doom Buggy. Yeah. Although, Zachary, I like your suggestion of the Ghoulmobile. That actually sounds nice. I like that.
I knew it was a pun. I knew it was a pun on something, just I didn't get the right pun.
So I know we got one more question left, all right? There is a tie for first place right now between Justin and Melissa at
Woo-hoo!
29. Woo. So no pressure. I've never had a show where we've had a tie, and I don't know what we're going to do. So we're going to find out if that's what happens here. But
all right. Like I said, I got some backup questions here if we need to take this into overtime.
at several Disney parks, a statue featuring Walt Disney and Mickey Mouse holding hands greets visitors as they first enter the park. What is the name of the statue?
Oh, come on.
I can see the statue in my head.
It's iconic.
Christmas ornaments of this. I have t-shirts of this. I have so much stuff. So, and the last time I did Disney trivia for my friends, this was actually one of the questions I asked.
Oh, look out. Oh,
so you better get this one right.
I better. Or I lied to my friends. So
yeah, I was half expecting you to say, I've got the Christmas ornaments, I've got the t-shirts, but I just can't remember the name.
All right, Jesse, who did you say was tied for first place?
Justin and Melissa both have 29 points. Yeah, that's for first place.
Because they and Zachary got this right.
Wow. All right.
The statue is called Partners.
So we're going into overtime.
What are the underground tunnels at Disney parks called?
Oh, wow. Spell check.
I've actually gotten to go down into them.
Look it up.
Oh, you can do a behind the scenes tour.
Yeah. No, this is really, it's really interesting. They're these literally underground hidden tunnels for people in costume and other cast members to make their way around the park. So you don't have, you don't have to worry about seeing two Mickey Mouses or something if they're heading to different sections.
Yeah. That's technically the park is on the second story of the property.
I almost just said that. Oh, my God. Technically, the ground level, the entire park is on the second level.
I feel like you guys been on the same tour or something. I don't know.
You're the same quiz show.
David, do you want to answer?
I'll pass on that. Just my luck at it. Oh, yeah, they're called passes.
Actually, Zach, can you tell them what you wrote? Because I just love this answer.
Place where they store all the Marvel money.
Unfortunately, you guys both got it right. It's the Utilidors.
So we got 33 apiece now.
You could really tell this park wasn't designed by engineers because they'd have just called them underground tunnels.
Right.
All right. Another tiebreaker. When Walt Disney passed away in 1966, he died during the production of which animated Disney film?
When did he pass away again?
December of 66.
Yep. 66, okay.
Yeah, sadly, that's what happens when you smoke as much as he did. It's actually interesting.
Far alive.
Well, no, he was such a hardcore smoker. There was they opened up, I can't remember if this was in Disneyland or I think it was in Disneyland. They actually had a tobacco shop that he would frequent.
Wow. Those crazy times.
Yeah. There was a store on Main Street USA in Disneyland in 55 where you could actually buy women's undergarments. The Main Street Brasserie. I don't know how you said it, but yeah, you could literally walk in and go, you know, I'd like a Mickey bar and a bra. So let's make that happen.
Did they make a Mickey bra?
I don't think so. The ears would poke.
That was a style though back in the day, wasn't it?
Exactly.
Yeah, and you put an onion through your belt.
Which was the style at the time.
Yes. Hi, Robert.
Justin broke the tie. The answer was Jungle Book.
Oh, wow. Justin, congratulations. I have never seen such a game in my entire five episodes I've done this. Either five or six. Anyway.
It was epic.
Yes, it was. So total points. David Wright comes in with a total of 17 points. Then in third place, Zachary has a total.
I don't even have a number anymore.
I was hoping he wouldn't catch that. David Wright.
How has he scored?
David Wright, total of 17 in fourth place. Zachary with 23 points in third place. Melissa in second place with a total of 33. And this month's Trip Up Trivia champion, Justin Lowe, with a total of 35 points. Ladies and gentlemen, what a game. Congratulations, Justin. Thank you all for playing. My goodness, that was great. Alexis.
All right. Well, before we start doing plugs, just to let everyone know that when we record next month, Tripped Up Trivia's theme for December is, wow, what a shocker, it's Christmas. Mm-hmm. We're going to do everything holiday related. The three categories are going to be Christmas movies, Christmas songs, and Christmas traditions.
Before we head into plugs, this would be a good time to tell you about a sponsor of the W2M Network, and that is Grammarly. For you, the listeners of Tripped Up Trivia, Grammarly is offering a free download of of the Grammarly software. Grammarly's AI-powered products help people communicate more effectively. It also helps you write mistake-free on Gmail, Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, and nearly anywhere else you write on the web. Grammarly corrects hundreds of grammar, punctuation, and spelling mistakes, and while also catching contextual errors, improving your vocabulary, and suggesting style improvements. To download Grammarly today, go to getgrammarly.com/W2M network. Again, that's getgrammarly.com/W2M network to download Grammarly for free.
If I may, as this episode is airing, it is in line with our review of Encanto, which will have come out the previous Wednesday. So check that out. We also have reviews of You Season 2, featuring, I'm sure, will be a drunk Pat Mullen and a even drunker and more inappropriate Jason Teasley. Speaking of Jason Teasley, we'll have a review of Resident Evil Welcome to Raccoon City starring Mickey Mouse. No, wait, never mind.
I wasn't expecting that.
We'll have a re-airing of our Lost in Space Season 1 TV party that David and I did. Hi, David.
Hi, Mark.
Miss you. Love you.
You too.
Myself and Robert Winfrey will be doing a triple feature for Bruised, Born a Champion, and Warrior. It's an MMA-focused triple feature. Isn't that fun, Jesse?
That sounds violent.
Speaking of violence, myself and Alexis Haina will be reviewing Animaniacs Season 2.
Nice.
And finally, Chris Bailey, myself and Ronnie Adams of the Screaming Boy podcast will be reviewing Why the Last Man Season 1.
Mark got his plugs in there. Way to go. Woo-hoo! All right, Alexis.
If you're interested in playing in next month's trivia game, hit us up on Facebook or Twitter. Let us know that you are interested. We're going to be looking for contestants here very soon.
Okay.
Now then, let's go ahead. Just before you and I do our plugs, let's let our wonderful contestants talk about anything they want to talk about. David, you want to go ahead and share your plugs?
Yeah. Well, if my answer to the Gargoyle Star Trek actor question was the highlight of the podcast for you, or even if it wasn't, I recommend you check out the third Star Trek movie retrospective podcast just released this last weekend, where Mark, Robert, and I talked about the Kelvin timeline Star Trek movies. So those are the newer ones with Chris Pine and Simon Pegg, Zachary Quinto, and so on. And also tune in to hear Mark and Robert's extended discussion on the relevance of the Beastie Boys and the appropriateness of the Star Trek franchise if you want. And I think other than that, I think next thing is early December, I'll be joining Mark and Alexis talking about the Cowboy Bebop live action Netflix series.
Zachary, I believe you're next. You want to tell us about your books?
Yes. So I make books. They're called Tallinn books. I call them books for kids, like 7 and up, though. Ones they could read with their kids, like parents could read with their kids and still enjoy. Our hit seller is Dinosaurs on the Moon, which is doing very well. They're on Amazon. All the books are on Amazon. You type in Tallinn books or you type in Zachary Strobel and books and they should come up. And they're not expensive. They're like $7 each. Alexis actually does a lot of the post-production work for some of the books. They're very good. You want to get your kids more into reading, Tallinn books.
Okay. All right. Justin?
I am an absolute fraud. I create no content whatsoever. But for all those out there, I humbly suggest in your free time, you check out Kapow, the pop cultured podcast, comic books, TV, movies, everything you may ever want to know about the show Riverdale in exhaustive detail, run by my brother and some really good folks wherever podcasts may be found. But other than that, I literally bring nothing to the table, but I've had a really good time. I appreciate you guys opening your hearts and your microphones up to a poor flatlander like me. And I've had a really good time. So thanks to everybody.
Melissa, I mean, your husband kind of jumped in there.
I was going to say, I'm very rarely on any of the podcasts. But I do know on tomorrow night, he's recording one with actually one of my best friends, 3 different musicals. And he made me suffer through one of them. Actually, I watched 2 of the 3 with him, but one of them was absolutely terrible. Yeah. Tick Tick Boom was good. Diana the Musical, not good. Tick Tick Boom, good. Okay. So he's going to be reading that with my best friend, Elizabeth. But that's really, I mean, like, that's, I would promote that one with my friend.
Okay. All right. Very good. Very good.
My cares, that will have already passed.
Well, I don't know. I'm just saying.
Consult me.
Oh, don't listen to him.
You hear how I get dealt with? Apparently, Jonas is in a podcast.
Yes.
Okay.
Jonas, do you want to plug your podcast?
Yes. Me and my dad will be doing it, a triple feature for Home Alone, 8-Bit Christmas, and Clifford the Big Red Dog.
Love it. How many dabs are you going to do during the podcast?
Probably at least over 1,000.
Over 1,000.
All right. Yes. Fantastic. I want pictures of every single dab. All right, then.
Of course, I got to do my plug for Honeysuckle Rose Creations, the intersection of geek and chic. We're getting ready to kick off our Black Friday sale. Everything in both of our Etsy and Handmade and Amazon shops is going to be 20% off. And we are also kicking off, along with this, our annual charity drive. From Black Friday to Christmas Eve, every individual order that is placed for both shops, we will be donating $5 to St. Jude's Children's Hospital. So go ahead and head over to our shop if you want to help us give back to those in need. Again, you can always follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, and our shops are open and fully stocked on Etsy and Handmade at Amazon. That's Honeysuckle Rose Creations, the intersection of geek and chic.
Okay. All right. Yeah. Just for me, real quick, I do a podcast called Source Material. It's comics focused, kind of like a book club for comics, where I bring on a guest and we talk about a specific book, a specific comic book, specific comic series. Just kind of keep an eye out, because December is going to be Spider-Verse. Got a 4-episode epic that's coming at you, where me and Benjamin J. Cologne sat down and talked Spider-Verse. So watch out for that. But other than that, you can follow me at Stiznarchy on Twitter if you do so wish. And with that being said, for Alexis Haina, for Justin Lowe, for Zachary Strobel, for Melissa Radlich, and for David Wright, I'm Jesse Starcher. We're out of here. See you next time on Tripped Up Trivia. Have a good one. Bye-bye.